Welcome back to Talk of the Town. After spending the majority of his career in the marketing, advertising, and package design business, and currently residing just outside Hilton Head in South Carolina, Richard Carl Roth joins Talk of the Town to tell us about his latest career and introduce his meticulously researched historical novel, Endangered Eagle. Richard, it's a pleasure to have you on the show.
It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. And how exciting, your first novel.
Right.
And you said probably your last.
Probably my last.
It took quite a bit of research.
Yes. I've been studying studying World War II for about 30, 35 years. Reason why? Because it's the most significant thing that happened in my lifetime, in terms of the way it changed the world and all the things that happened and all the horrible, horrible things that occurred. And for some reason or other, I was always interested in history, and then I decided that this is an area I wanted to spend some time on.
Yeah.
So I collected, for 30 years, I collected a great deal of information. I have a personal library of over 450 books at home on the subject. Plus, I've got newsreels and films and magazines and other books from the period. So I have a great deal of research material available. I originally thought I'd write a nonfiction book, but I realized pretty quickly that even though I had all of that, I couldn't match the other major historical novel historical people could write. So I decided to do the next best thing and write a historical novel. And a historical novel is a novel that takes place in an area, or I should say a period, and with people who actually did exist. So my story is built around actual events and actual people who in Berlin in 1936.
And the actual person, which I think is so interesting, is?
Well, the story basically is around Charles Lindbergh. Charles Lindbergh, the very famous aviator, who in 1927 flew from New York to Paris. He was an international hero. I mean, that's the only way to describe it. I don't even know if there's anybody today that would match that because the world was so totally different. But Charles Lindbergh actually visited Berlin July 22nd, 1936, right before the Summer Olympics, which were held in Berlin at that time. Interestingly, he went there on a spy mission, but he didn't know he was a spy. The military attaché at the American Embassy, Major Truman Smith, was trying to collect information on the German Air Force, which was rapidly growing under Hitler's regime. And military attaché's job is to be a spy, find out what's going on in the country that he's in. He couldn't collect the information, he just knew that they were doing a lot. His wife, Kay, actually saw an article in a French newspaper that when Charles Lindbergh visited France, the government took him to all the aviation facilities, and so Truman Smith got the idea, well, hey, maybe if they come here, do the same thing.
Right.
So he contacted Hermann Goering, who was in charge of the Luftwaffe, German Air Force. And Goering loved the idea that a man of Lindbergh's stature would come there. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And what happened, very simply, Goering had Lindbergh taken everywhere, and Major Smith went with him. And at the end of the day, they'd sit back and write a report and sent it back to Washington about what was happening and how the Air Force was being developed.
Wow.
So that's the setting for it. And the basic story is that the part that I made up was that they discovered right before Lindbergh was to arrive that there was a plot to assassinate him.
Wow.
And the question
that's
is
a,
why. That,
yeah, that's a thriller. That's absolutely a thriller. So, yeah. I mean, it's amazing that you've written this novel and the research that's gone into it. And so what kind of responses have you received from the book? The book has released, correct?
Oh, yes. The book has been released in 2012. Responses have been quite good. We've entered in a couple of contests. And in fact, it won a finalist award in an international book contest last year.
Congratulations.
Yes,
that's amazing.
Yeah, that was really good. I beat out about 70 other books. And I got beaten by a New York Times best-selling author, so I feel pretty good about that.
That's right.
Yeah, and the book has been, the response has been pretty good, yes.
And so where is the book available?
The book is available online, primarily, on Amazon and on Barnes & Noble. It's available as a hard copy, and it's also available as Kindle and Nook, an e-book.
And I mentioned that this may be your last book, and it was really primarily because it was funny what you had said before we opened the show.
Yeah. Well, it's I spent a lot of time. I mean, the thing about this book is the historical accuracy. If I say that there was a police station at 23rd Kreuzbergstrasse, which means Kreuzberg Street, there was a police station there. If I say it was across the street from Victoria Park, it was across the street from Victoria Park. When I identify a restaurant and describe what's inside, what the inside looks like,
it's a valid restaurant.
It's a valid restaurant, and I have pictures of the interior, so it is extremely accurate. And in addition to the fictional characters, I use people who really did exist.
Yeah. Richard, extremely interesting, and best of luck in the sale of the book, and Endangered Eagle, pick up a copy.
Yes, good. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you so much. Right. And we thank you so much for joining us on today's Talk of the Town.